How about the Washington football team? Are you kidding me? What a win from them. Let's just start things off with what ended up being the really the, this kind of sealed the game, the interception. So it's kind of a funny play. You know, it's a pretty simple play. It's a cover two zone. They just sort of have a receiver who's going to run over the middle. Then Big Ben can simply just hit his halfback in the flat. This could pick up a few yards. Maybe it could pick up a first down. They're just trying to start things off small. You don't have to go too quickly. You only need a field goal to tie the game. And there is, 2 minutes and 4 seconds. So plenty of time. And the clock's going to get stopped after this play. But Ben takes the snap, makes a quick throw, and Montez Sweat bats it up in the air, which, you know, one of the things that we kind of talked about going into this game was how effective would the pass rush really be against a quarterback who gets rid of the ball really quickly. Well, that's one way to be effective, knocking the ball up in the air. But I wanted to pause it right here because you notice John Bostic for Washington, he's not in the best position right here. There's another Pittsburgh player who's closer to where the ball is going to end up, but he just doesn't read this, whereas Bostic does read this, and he reads this very quickly. He's able to make the break and get that interception, just great awareness from him. I mean, yes, he was facing that way, but that's still very difficult to make, so give him a ton of credit for the awareness. Then there was this play, which this play was what set up the game-winning field goal. This is a huge play. It's third down and four. If they don't get it here, Pittsburgh has a chance to potentially go down the field, kick a field goal of their own, and you know who knows what happens if they know that they don't have to score a field goal. Maybe that changes things. It's a cover one play, and for Washington, they have a Haas concept on the top of the screen. That's one base. It's a halfback actually closest to the top of the screen. There's a linebacker on him. He's just gonna run a few steps, run past the first down marker, but then stop. You didn't have a receiver running deep, and that's what you hope. You hope that he can get open since there's only one safety deep. Alex Smith takes the snap. He is going to take this chance here. He didn't always take chances throughout this game, but this time he did. And there is a window, but not a huge window. This is going to take a really good throw and a really good catch. But that's what happens. Perfect throw. And Cam Sims with the one-handed grab. What a day he had. It looked like he was getting interfered with a little bit, but still makes the grab. Just incredible. And that set up the game-winning field goal. So yeah, I mean, this was definitely a wild ending, no doubt about it. Now, it wasn't always a perfect game. For Washington, to say the least, there were some sloppy bits. Obviously, you beat an undefeated team. It's good. But I want to talk a little bit about, first I want to talk about something that some people consider a negative that I actually sort of thought was fun, which was the trick play that they tried earlier on. The way it works is they start off in five wide. Alex Smith is in the shotgun, but then what they're going to do is they have Logan Thomas. He ran over, and he's now the player who's under center. He used to play quarterback, so he knows how to take a snap. He's just going to then give a quick handoff to a receiver who's going to run in motion to the right side of the screen. And this is actually, I think this is really clever, because watch what happens really before the ball is even snapped. Look in the middle and watch how all of those Pittsburgh players they're trying to cover up a potential quarterback sneak, because that makes sense, right? That seems logical, and something that you might do is you have Logan Thomas come in, he takes the snap under center, runs a quarterback sneak, and Washington has actually done that before this season, so it would make sense. But look in that yellow box right there. The guy I want you to take a look at is Mike Hilton. That's the defensive back for Pittsburgh. He's going to come in huge in this play because, again, there's no one really containing the edge right there, which is why it makes sense for Washington to do this, is why I think it's a smart play. But he's just going to read this play really well. You notice how he's already taken a couple of snaps towards the inside of the player who's going to be blocking him right here. And, you know, typically a quarterback could look up, notice that, sort of help out his player, say, hey, make sure you block to the inside, or you could just notice it at the line. But really, this is just a great read from Mike Hilton. He crashes in, and he's going to be able to make this quick tackle. If he doesn't do that, that's an easy first down. So, really good job by him, because I should have mentioned this at the beginning of the play. This was a 4th-and-1, so that was a huge swing in that football game. And I personally wanted to see Alex Smith play a little bit more aggressive, but maybe playing cautious was the better approach. I don't know. But there definitely were moments that I noticed that he was being a bit too cautious. You know, we saw Pittsburgh blitz a good amount in this game, and the commentators said in this one that Pittsburgh basically has the mindset of they like to rush 4, but if they need to rush more to get pressure, they're fine with doing that. They're going to rush 5 on this play, but it's actually going to end up being 6 because it's man coverage. A halfback is just going to block for Washington, so then a linebacker, he's also going to rush the passer. He just follows what he sees the halfback doing. They would do the same thing if there was a tight end blocking on this play, but he's running a route, so it'll be essentially it's going to be a six-man rush with six blockers. If you noticed, I've circled a route that I find interesting. 83, the wide receiver, he's running a route that looks like it should be able to get open pretty quickly. There's a cornerback who's covering him who's pretty far off. And what Pittsburgh is actually going to do on this play is they're going to end up switching once they realize what's going on, which means that it'll actually be the defensive back who's in charge of covering 82 on that side of the field. He's going to cover the middle of the field, but that's definitely a route Smith could look towards. He's also going to look towards his right. There's a quick out route that'll be past the first down marker, so those are the couple of plays that Smith is going to look towards. This is a second down and nine. There's only 24 seconds left in the half, but you can work over the middle of the field, and the out routes would be really good. So I understand why he's looking towards his right first. And watch, once this ball is snapped, you're going to notice that he does look to his right, and for some reason, he's not going to make this throw. I think he could. It's dangerous because, you know, if a defensive back makes a clean break, he could get an interception, maybe a pick six. That is possible, so it's a risk. But, I mean, I kind of had the mindset of if you're playing an 11-0 team, take some risk because you're going to need a little bit of luck to beat the Pittsburgh Steelers. But that's not what Smith wants to do. Smith could just throw the check down, which he also loves to do, over the middle. He's not going to do that either, which I think you have to, if you're not going to make that out route now, hit the check down. But I think he just doesn't want to, you know, have to hurry up and burn a timeout. Smith holds on to it for too long, ends up taking a sack, which was a really bad situation. He ended up taking a sack on the next play as well. That didn't end up mattering. They still got the field goal, thanks to a little bit of help from the refs not realizing it was Alex Smith who took the ball away in that weird situation. But yeah, you know, good job by Pittsburgh. Not the best read from Alex Smith, but good job by Pittsburgh for not letting anything be open enough that Smith wanted to make the throw and then getting the pressure there quickly. So yes, it was Smith not doing a great job, I think, but at the same time, Pittsburgh just made it difficult on Alex Smith. So yeah, I mean, truly incredible win. This was the only game I got wrong in my weekly pick'em thing, and I'm not even mad about it, because what a game, you know? I mean, the Giants, we thought that was going to be the biggest upset of the week, and now Washington says, hey, we're legit too. We can win some good games. So just, you know, incredible job by them. They deserve a ton of credit, and with a 3-17 victory, they were able to win. Just awesome.